Hey yo, YouTube, what's going on? Junior here, back again with another reaction video, back again with another request, and as you can see, I'm wearing the dope hat. I got this old red t-shirt on. Name a more iconic duo. What does that even mean, you're asking? Well, guys, we hit 1,000 subscribers, and I couldn't have done it without all 1,000 of you, of course, obviously. That's, what I'm supposed to be saying. But of course, I'm pretty cool too. I was thinking of doing potentially like a Q&A, a little Q&A. If you guys had any questions about, I don't know, music, whatever. If I get enough little responses to that, I could do a little video about that. So if you have any questions for me for a little Q&A, leave them down below. Heck, maybe I'll answer them. Who knows? I didn't think that I would be able to hit 1,000 before the end of October. It's super cool. I mean, I can't believe that this channel has kind of taken off like this. I mean, 1,000 really isn't that big of a deal. But I feel like for a starting out YouTuber content creator, it's a good milestone. You know, I'm pretty happy with that. I'm happy that you guys are enjoying my videos. I'm happy you guys are communicating with me and stuff, and I don't know, I thought we'd celebrate by doing another tool video, because, you know, what else do I do on this channel? Going forward, since I want more diversity of music on this channel, it won't be every 100, because it's just like every two or three videos ends up being a tool video, so we gotta like slow down a bit, but, you know, we'll still keep tool on for the milestones, I just haven't decided when. We're gonna be listening to the song Stink Fist, requested by David Howard, Samadu Tone, and Ricky Garlic. Ricky Garitz. Thank you so much for the 1,000 subscribers. Yeah, this is good. I'm already enjoying this. Looking at these lyrics here, it seems like the theme of this song is, I guess, perhaps getting desensitized to things around you and needing constant overstimulations, going to the extreme for any sense of feeling. You know, coming to the lyrics, something has to change, undeniable dilemma. Boredom's not a burden anyone should bear. Boredom is the worst thing that anybody should be ever subjected to. You know, it's just that unspeakable torture that we are constantly trying to escape. Constant overstimulation numbs me, but I wouldn't want you any other way. And I see this, you know, I even feel this, you know, I constantly have to be consuming media all the time, listening to music, watching videos, researching, doing work. I have to be doing something, because if I don't, then I'm just like, huh, you know, I'm just sitting here, but I could be watching something. I could be learning something, or I could be, you know, wasting my time watching something dumb, you know, but you need that constant stimulation of your brain to just not feel bored. You know, you can't just sit around and chill out anymore. You need something there. You need to be doing something all the time. And I think this song is just about it's just about the extremities of this, you know. It's not enough. I need more. Nothing seems to satisfy. I said I don't want it. I just need it to breathe, to feel, to know I'm alive. Yeah, so that's the thing. Like, it's not even like these things are a luxury or a privilege anymore. It's like become a necessity of our lifestyle. Yikes. Okay. Look, I'm sure you guys know how this taking things to the extreme, you know, lines up with the analogy, the image of Stinkfist. I'm sure I don't have to explain what's going on here, okay? Because let's take a look at these lyrics. Finger deep within the borderline. And I think the borderline representing, you know, that threshold, that line with which we're constantly trying to push past to, you know, to feel, to be stimulated by media, by, you know, by whatever, by what life has to offer. But, you know, it's also a metaphor for, you know, show me that you love me and that we belong together. Relax, turn around and take my hand. I mean, take my hand or, you know, take my hand. Something just so brutally animalistic and claustrophobic with this atmosphere and instrumental that Tool's making with the song. It just kind of like seems to echo solely inside of myself and not going to the exterior. Which I maybe, you know, relates to this, to the point of the song where it's telling you to make you take a look at yourself. Shut off all of the exterior influences in your life. Take a look inside yourself. Are you content with just being, or are these things that you constantly distract yourself with, a crutch that you lean on in order to feel fulfilled in life, feel like you're doing something worthwhile while actually not accomplishing anything? I mean, I'm also looking way too deep into it, so I mean, I'm reaching a little too far, you know, if you know what I'm saying. It is in the lyrics right there. Something sad about the way that things have come to be, desensitized to everything. What became of subtlety? I mean, this character in this song, the narrator or whatever, these people who are, they're like blinded or just so numb. Everything's just so kind of one note and gray to them. They go to the utmost extremes, mental, physical, psychological stimulation, torment, in order not even just to enjoy themselves, but in order just to like feel something. It's like getting desensitized to violence in movies and video games, whatever. And you know, that's a pretty hot button topic, or like even getting desensitized to heavier types of music. You know, when you start listening to metal, I don't know, Disturbed is the most extreme thing you've ever heard in your life. But as you kind of get more into that, I think you realize that no, it's actually not. Rambo is definitely not the most violent movie you've ever seen in your life. Like, things can always get worse, and people kind of get used to them and kind of start seeking out the absolute extremities of everything. You know, I do that too. Like, I enjoy watching extreme cinema just to see if I can, you know, just because they're labeled as extreme. So I'm like, ah, well, it's almost like a challenge. And then you can only watch that for a while, and you're like, all right, well, this is just kind of what I watch now, or this is what I listen to now, or these are the kind of movies I like, you know. It just kind of keeps going further and further. However, do I think there's anything necessarily wrong with that? I don't know. I think that's a very multifaceted topic and issue that could take a very long discussion, especially since like movies, music, games, like those are all kind of different medium. Does playing violent video games make you violent? No, I don't think so. Does watching extreme cinema make you a disturbed, deranged psychopath? No, I don't think so. I think I'm pretty normal. Does listening to heavy metal make you a deviant, demon-worshipping cultist? No, I don't think so. I think it's up to each individual and how they perceive, process the media that's put in front of them. If you kind of like have the mental fortitude and the awareness kind of realize that, you know, these things are just for entertainment, they don't need to affect your life, or you don't need to like rely on them to influence your life, then I think it's okay. Not that there's anything wrong with getting influenced by media and art, because I think that's a very viable way to kind of like discover what you like and how you can express yourself. But of course, it's always taking things a bit too far. I think all in all, as long as you're kind of aware that it's you don't need to take it too seriously. Or at least you should really think about it if you are. You know, it's fine. I'm probably going too deep into this, so I'm just gonna chill out for a bit. Like, these people have now flayed themselves in this video, you know? They no longer have skin, which is probably one of the most extreme forms of self-mutilation I could think of. Which reminds me of the ending of one movie that I saw called Martyrs. If any of you have seen that movie, it's pretty crazy. That was Stink Fist. See, like, in the last little verse there, the lyrics, elbow deep inside the borderline. Two lines later, shoulder deep within the borderline. See, it just, you guys kind of just keep going farther and farther, pushing that line farther and farther until, you know, irreparable damage, perhaps. But, I mean, look, guys, overall, of course I enjoyed this song. It's dynamic, it's crazy, it's intricate, it's complicated. You know? Made me feel a lot of things, made me think about a lot of things. Obviously, you said I just went off on a big ramble at the end there, so yeah, very cool. Yeah, there's even a line here that says, this may hurt a little, but it's something you'll get used to. Relax, slip away. Yeah, crazy song, crazy video. I love the visuals for that too. I mean, look guys, thanks for watching. Thanks for watching my video. Thanks for watching my channel this whole time and keeping up to date with me. And look, like I said at the beginning, if you guys have any questions for a possible potential Q&A video that I would release sometime soon, then leave them in the comment section down below, you know, along with your song suggestions, and maybe I'll do one. I don't know. Well, I'll just see how the response goes. But I just want to say thanks, you know? I wouldn't have gone to 1,000 without 1,000 people hitting subscribe. So if that wasn't obvious enough, there we go. Yeah, I think it's a little ridiculous, this whole thing. But, I ain't gonna complain. I'm having fun. I'm listening to music, and I'm basically using this channel as an excuse to listen to music and have cool discussions with people. So why the hell not? Let's keep it going. Let's keep this train on the tracks. Let's not derail it just yet. So my name's Junio. I'm signing out. Y'all are dope. And I'll see you tomorrow?